I'll now request Dr. Zora Singh, our chief guest of honor. So Dr. Zora Singh is Chancellor for Deshbhagat University. He started his profession as a doctor and practiced as a child specialist for 15 years before his calling to do something for the society led him into the field of education. And starting in 1996, he has successfully established 21 education institutions across Punjab, Chandigarh and Kenya. They were accorded the university status by Government of Punjab in 2012. He has been socially active, member of large number of organizations, which last list runs into 4 pages. He is a philanthropist also, started an NGO, Hara Punjab, Khara Punjab, which is committed to the environmental protection, routing out social evils like female fratricide, dowry, drug abuse. This organization has been instrumental in distributing almost 60,000 saplings for Greening Punjab, and the target is to distribute 1 lakh. He has much awarded and person. I have privileged to present before you Dr. Zora Singh.
Thank you, Anagji. On the occasion of the panel discussion on bridging gaps, demystifying skill development, and also the release of a study, a report by this company, I welcome the chief guest of today, Shri Honorable Minister, Mr. Madan Mittalji, Honorable Minister for Technical Education, Industry and Commerce. I welcome the other panelists. I welcome Mr. Anurag Ji, Rohit Chawla, Gagan Chawda Ji. I welcome my friend Dhrinder Ji, Mal Sahab, my colleagues, and the most honored press members. I welcome you all over here. This company, Bridging Gaps, I was confused first that whether they are Bridging Gaps or they are the name of the company. Finally, I settled it is the name of the company only because I was knowing Mr. Anurag only for the years, but not the name of the company. And they're doing a UN task to bridge this gap between the academia and industry. As the vital figures were given, data was given that 25 or 30% manpower which is being generated by the Indian education industry is not employable. So it's a very, very vital issue, and of course this company is tigering the manpower. They are empowering the manpower to make them employable. As I was going through the observations of Mr. Kamal Bhardwaji, he rightly said that why the industry should teach the youngsters when they have come from the institution, they have qualified, they have obtained a degree or postgraduate or diploma whatsoever, but they're not employable, they have to train. But I feel, of course it's true, that whatsoever the organization structure is, any newcomer, however qualified he might be, he always has to be taught and imbibed in the setup, and he has to given some the value system of the company, value system of the organization, the overall environment of the company. And this is the part of the thing, but the main emphasis given by him was that there's a gap, and why the industry, and this gap is being filled by this bridging gap company. And this skill development, I think we were talking about two different verticals. One was the skill development as a skill development initiated by the Government of India and the Government of Punjab. As South India came into higher education about 3 decades back, while North India came into higher education about 2 decades back. We were laggard by 1 decade from the South India. And for the last about a decade or so, we are talking about skill development. It may be the Prime Minister of the country and the Honorable Chief Minister of the state. They are emphasizing right now on the skill development. And the skill development, we talk on every forum. And I found some of the issues with the NSDC as well. I was given to understand that we started this NSDC programs about 7-8 years back. And then the issue was that there was a condition, I don't know whether it's the government of India or the government of Punjab condition, that you will have to show this much of employability. Only then you will be given the next batch. So some of the, I think these are the bureaucratic hurdles. Let's come to the grassroots level, understand the difficulties of the institutions as well, and then push it up for further implementation of the programs. If we simply said that you first employ 25% and then really it was reduced, for first is 50%, then 25%, then it's 10%. But is it applicable? Does, can any government can commit this thing that we will give this minimum employment? Let's be practical and let's be more realistic about the issues. The issue of honing of the skills. One is, as Ms. Malvika told, that one is the giving the skills, and second is upgrading the skills, honing the skills. And honing the skill, we involve basically and most important constituent of that is the communication skills, of course. Of course, the improvement of the behavioral techniques and other things as well, so that we can find a person who is really ready to join the market, but he's not suitable to join the market. How we can hone these skills, like handling of phone, interview skills, and such things. So we need to create a manpower who can handle phones, who can handle manpower at the front desk, and likewise they can communicate very well. They might be knowing a great deal of knowledge in them, but they cannot express. And maybe our nurses or doctors, they have to clear the IELTS examination, they go abroad. I was in North America only 10 days back for a short trip of 15 days. What I found that I was taken to the, first of all, they call the state assembly as the parliament. I was taken to the Ontario parliament there, and they made a mention of my name, acknowledged and all that. There is a leave about this issue. And what I came to know about the integrity and the transparency of the working of the countries, that the Prime Minister of Ontario, and for that matter of other states as well, he is not entitled to have a chauffeur. I couldn't believe. And they said that the governor of the state is entitled to have chauffeur for one day when there is some official function. So we have to come up with that. I said, why it's so? They said that he draws a salary and he doesn't afford the driver. And the dignity of labor is such that you go any house there, they will tell you to remove your shoes first of all. Why? I was just jiving with somebody, and like that. It was in every house. They said that we have to clean our house every ourselves only. It may be the toilet, it may be the floor, it may be other things. We have to do ourselves. And I said, you don't have the manpower to clean it. They said, we can hire, but then we'll have to pay minimum wages of $10 per hour. And we also earn this much. So, when we talk about the skill development and the upgradation of the skill, honing of skills, the dignity of a labor should also be emphasized. And we should believe that whatsoever we are doing for our own self, for our own community, for our own society, for our own nation, and for our own mother earth. At Desh Bhagat, we are running this faculty development programs to hone up the skills, the communication skills programs as well, faculty development programs as well. We keep on interacting with the industry. Every fortnight we call some industries there. We ask their needs and we ask their problems they face with the youngsters and all that. And we keep on propping up whatsoever the grey areas, how to seal them, and how to make more vibrant curriculum. And today is a great day when the industry, academia, and the government as well is together here. Because it's the three prongs of this issue, who can solve this issue. Because most of the times I have attended so many industry, academia interface, but the government is missing. Now the government is amongst us, and particularly the relevant minister is also with us. So we can today forge some sort of alliance. I had the opportunity to invite Mr. Madan Mittal ji in my institute only 20 days back, 25 days back. So he was very generous to talk to my students, even faculty. And at every level, he understood the problem of the private institutes. And he lauded the role of private institutes. And I believe that the private institutes who are contributing in Punjab particularly 97% of higher education, they should be acknowledged and they should be given their due share. And that's all. Thank you very much. All